In today's video, we're gonna take a look at using the AI assistant from within Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. I currently have a sample document open that already has been made accessible. And just a friendly reminder to hit that subscribe button to help me grow to 5,000 subscribers. And Adobe Acrobat has recently released what is called the AI assistant. It appears to only work for small documents, but we're gonna poke around and see what we can do. The first thing I'm going to do is select the AI assistant button. It will then begin processing the document. And what we have is a simple overview. The document is about providing guidelines and examples for creating alternate text descriptions for images and ensuring accessibility in various contexts. That's perfect. Here are some suggestions you can try. We can ask it basically a question. So I'm gonna ask it to provide a list of the 5 most important points. And it gives us a decent list of the 5 most important points. It says context is most important when providing for alternate text of images. That's true. Decorative images should be marked as such to indicate that they do not convey any meaningful information. Also true. This is pretty great. I really like this AI assistant in terms of being able to communicate with our document. Let's see what it can do with another larger file. All right, I just opened up a anthropology file and I am running the AI assistant to see what comes up. It will be interesting because I don't think that this document is tagged or accessible. So I'm curious to see how the results will be for an inaccessible doc. Interesting, so it did provide me an overview. The document is about physical anthropology and its role in explaining human evolution and our relationship to past and present organisms. And it has some proposed questions that we can ask it. This is very interesting. So it gives us a whole bunch of information about the anthropology. I'm gonna ask it, can you provide me a list of headings? That's pretty cool. We also can engage with the content by selecting the number icon. Interesting. It doesn't pick up all of them, but it does pick up some of them, which is pretty cool. And if this was a tagged PDF, I would assume that all of the headings would show up. I wanna go back to my other document and I wanna ask it the same thing because this particular file is completely accessible. So let's ask it to, can you show me all of the headings in this document? Ooh, that's pretty good. Wow, interesting though, because it doesn't give me, it's kind of just randomly picking headings. Like on this one, it's picking a table of contents item, but not the word contents. So it's very clearly not perfect, but it's a pretty cool feature that it looks like you can have a conversation with your PDF. Now, I am personally very excited to see where the future of AI takes us, especially when we look at it from the lens of accessibility. There is a very strong chance that in the near future, students will be able to have full conversations with documents like we were able to see a sample of today, but I have a feeling it's gonna get a lot better and it will be able to consume a lot more content. Anyways, with that said, I am your personal accessibility expert. Thank you so much for joining me today as I explore a new feature in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, and I can't wait to see you next time.